I'm not sure if I will be able to show. Let me see. I probably can. I have to go to one of my projects. So this I'm working with some people, some producers or some rappers in Portugal, and we are doing a music project together. And one of the songs is from RX8, which is a good friend of mine, and we had an issue with one of the recordings. So I went to his studio and helped him record the vocals. And I didn't notice, only when he sent me the stems here when I came to Stuttgart, he sent me the stems, and we found, when I was editing the beat, we found there was a click on the vocal. And this sometimes can happen when you are singing in the microphone and the microphone just has some glitch, some electrical glitch or something like that, or something hit the microphone and created a click. And excuse me. And that sometimes is really hard, because let's say you have a really cool recording and you like the recording how it is, but you have a click on it. And it's really, really, sometimes it can be really hard to re-record stuff to get the same vibe, the same feeling. And if you cannot, that's kind of like a deal breaker, and you have to find ways to remove clicks from tracks. So the question that I have here is how to remove clicks from audio. And there's a couple of good plugins out there that can really help you to do this. And I bought a couple of them. So let me show you. So this is the project that I'm working with him. And here, this is the track that we had. And let me bring this down here. And let me just put this section here. You see here, at this point here, we have a click. And this is very annoying, because if it was with the entire beat, we wouldn't notice, but I made a break in the beats. As you can see, the loop, there's a break there, and it's right when I remove the loop, that's when I get this this click. And I was like, gosh, damn it, this is not good. So what I did was I bought some effects a couple of months ago from iZotope. And iZotope has one of the best plugins companies out there, and I really like their plugins. So let's go here and let's put this track on a different one. Let's go to 14 here, and let's go to iZotope RX8, and we have the declick, and we have the declip, which, if you have digital clipping, this can also sound really, really bad with your audio recording. So you can also have that. We have the humming. So I used to record some of my videos with some lapel microphone, and that lapel microphone had a lot of noise, a lot of hum, and this could also be a really cool way to remove that. So, but we are only interested in the click. And these tools or these plugins were quite inexpensive. They costed, I think, $20 or something like that, or 30, something like that. And I think for the tools, for a music producer that works with audio and some stems with some recordings from clients, that can also really, really help. And it's just a cheap option to have. So let's hear now this part here with the declick and without the declick, even without changing any parameters.
Então fui só querer autoajuda. Então fui só querer autoajuda.
So there's a little bit of delay, but let's take this out.
Então fui só querer autoajuda.
And completely removes the delay.
Então fui só querer.
The click.
Então fui só querer autoajuda. Então fui só.
So this is really, really cool. And the way that I did it was, I, instead of having the entire track with this declick, I just re-record this. So I went to MISC Edison. I went here and I placed this on play and I hit record.
Então fui só querer autoajuda. Então fui só querer.
Something like that. And then I brought this track into FL Studio, into the playlist, without the clicking. And then, as you can see here, I just have, I just cut the part that had the clicking, and then I put the replaced the part. Why I did this? Because I don't want extra processing on the vocal. And this can also can be really cool if you want to just attack a simple part of the audio that has a click, and you can clean that up. But you don't want these effects going through the entire track. If you do like humming, that probably something that you want to have the effect or the plugin inserted in the track here, and you want them here in the slots. But in this case, I just wanted to have that part cleaned out. So what I did was re-record this, and then I brought it into FL Studio like this. And I don't know what I did. I think I just messed up the project because I loaded. Yeah, I think I loaded the Edison stuff into the clip there, but there's no worries. I will not save this project. But the idea is that you just clean whatever you have to clean, and then you drag and drop the audio into the playlist, and then you replace it with the one that you want, or the clean one. And that's how you do. And to be honest, I've never checked this stuff here. I never checked what are the options. I just used the plugin as it is, and it worked. And it's really, really a good way to do declicking. To be honest, I don't know of any other plugin that does this type of stuff. So I don't have any other options or any other recommendations besides the RX8 declick. So